Brazil are tearing opponents apart in the 2022 World Cup qualifying stage, technical wonders from Neymar, the return of the Nations League, and the revelation of Iker Casillas. Club football is still on pause, but there are lots of top teams matches and other important news ahead of us. If you don't want to miss anything, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button. We try our best every day, just for you. Friends, yesterday there was a very beautiful date on the calendar, 10-10. Consequently, we are interested to know, who do you consider to be the best number 10 in modern football? Write your opinion in the comments below. For us to start off, it only remains to smash like for the video you're experiencing right at this moment. The management of Real Madrid intends to offer new contracts to Sergio Ramos and Luka Modric, whose contracts expire in the summer of 2021. In honour of the 100th goal for Portugal, Cristiano Ronaldo will play against France in boots with the CR100 inscription. That's what we call the top boots which Cristiano has. The situation with the coronavirus in Dortmund is becoming critical. The derby against Schalke will most likely be held without spectators. If I score against Barcelona, then I won't celebrate that action. But I will point out something to the stands, Marca quotes Suarez. Chelsea goalkeeper Eduard Mendy escaped serious injury. He'll miss a couple of weeks. Friends, if you speak Spanish, then feel free to subscribe to our new channel, Munda Football. Same newsfeed, only in Spanish. Links will be in the description, pinned comment, and closing title. Neymar broke Messi's record for the most acts of dribbling in one World Cup qualifier. Against Bolivia, he made 18 of them. I read with a smile that the transfer of Koulibaly was agreed. We didn't negotiate with him at all, said Man City COO Omar Barada. 17-year-old Barcelona forward Ansu Fati was named the best player in La Liga in September. Bayern winger Leroy Sané resumed individual training after injury. Barcelona plans to sell Ousmane Dembele in winter for €50 million. Milan wants to sign Marseille leader Florian Thauvin in the summer of 2021 as a free agent. Arsenal didn't negotiate the termination of the contract of Mesut Ozil. One of the clubs in Saudi Arabia offered Juan Mata a contract for €15 million per year. Right fullback of Bayer and Colombia, Santiago Arias suffered a terrible fracture of his leg in the game against Venezuela. I'm not going to sit on the bench all season. The more experience a player has, the less patient he becomes. Football Italia quotes Eriksen. Former Liverpool striker Robbie Fowler became the head coach of the Indian club East Bengal. Former Juventus coach Maurizio Sarri can lead Fiorentina. In September, Bayern Munich wanted to buy midfielder Federico Valverde from Real Madrid, but Madrid turned down the offer. Former Arsenal and West Ham midfielder Jack Wilshere seems interesting for Rangers. He is in free agent status. In the next game against West Ham, Gareth Bale will play for Tottenham for the first time since his return. Chelsea defender Victor Moses underwent a medical examination before moving to Spartak. Arsenal centre-back William Saliba is likely to go on loan to the Championship club Brentford. Juventus and Sami Khedira are in talks to terminate his contract, but the parties haven't yet come to an agreement. Deo Upamecano from RB Leipzig and James Tarkowski from Burnley, they are Manchester United's transfer goals for January. Former Bayern striker Sandro Wagner took over the German under-16 team. Bayern continues to negotiate on a new contract for David Alaba, but there is still no progress. Yesterday, the League of Nations was resumed, and the qualification for the 2022 World Cup in South America continued as well. And here are all the results. And we're moving on to the main juice of yesterday's news. Let's go! The national teams of Brazil and Colombia kicked off the qualification for the 2022 World Cup with victories. Seleção played at home against one of the weakest teams in the region, Bolivia. Moreover, in the 30th minute, Tite's team was leading 2-0. The score was opened by Marquinhos, and Firmino doubled the lead. And in the opening of the second half, the Liverpool forward scored a double and finally killed the intrigue. After that, the five-time world champions were simply horsing around on the pitch. Neymar rounded his opponents in stacks and scored two more goals. Carrasco's own goal and Coutinho's accurate shot made it 5-0. the most confident start of the qualification. Colombia played it cool as well while smashing Venezuela 3-0. In this game, the duo from Atalanta, Zapata and Muriel, were on fire. Devan opened the scoreline and Luis scored a brace before the break. Real Madrid legend Iker Casillas said that Jose Mourinho was from the first ones to ask about his health condition after a heart attack. Many don't know this, but Jose Mourinho was one of the first who called me after a heart attack to find out how I felt, ESPN quotes Casillas. This is surprising, because during the reign of Mourinho, Casillas lost his place at the side of Real Madrid and was forced to leave his native club. The media sources constantly talked about the conflict between the special one and the former captain of the Merengues. The national teams of Germany and Spain confirmed their status as the clear favourites in yesterday's UEFA Nations League matches. Joachim Löw's team defeated the Ukrainian national team, weakened by the coronavirus and injuries, 1-2. Especially worth noting is the first goal of the Germans, when after the standard, three central defenders of the team played an amazing combination. Rüdiger outplayed two players, passed the ball to Zule, and he rolled it out onto the empty net to Ginter. The Germans scored the second one after a terrible mistake by goalkeeper Gheorghe Bashan, who simply pushed the ball on Leon Goretzka's head. Ruslan Malinovsky returned the intrigue from the penalty spot, but Ukraine didn't have enough strength to fight back, even for an equaliser. It is amazing that for Germany, this victory was the first in the history of the team's performance in the League of Nations. Before that, she had four draws and two defeats. Spain, in turn, had an overwhelming advantage against Switzerland, but won only with a minimum score of 1-0, the winning goal in the first half. Mikel Oyarzabal intercepted a pass of the central defenders and kicked it near Jan Sommer. Poor defence of the Bolivian national team. Yesterday, Neymar did whatever he wanted to. The leader of PSG made just a bunch of rounds and sent the defenders of Bolivia for a hot dog race over and over again. Just look at how Neymar nutmegged the opponent and almost completed the offense with a spectacular feint of Zidane. Unbelievable. Here I just have no words. Not only did he chip-shotted the opponent, but also humiliated him with a gorgeous heel pass. Bravo, Neymar. It's amazing how, with having such a shape for the game, Ney left the pitch without goals or assists. Well, at least Messi broke the record. Friends, we remind you about our new channel, Munda Football. Support us by subscribing, viewing, and liking. The video is in front of you. Go and check it out. It's time for us to say goodbye. Good mood and good health to everyone. Bye bye.